Okay, here we are getting ready to install a set of taco outriggers on a 219 FS QS boat. As you can see, we've already got the pre-welded on plates that came with the T-top, so it gives us a nice hole to start with. And we are going to drill some holes. 3 1/8 inch hole saw. It's a pretty big hole to be drilling in a new boat, so a little bit scary at first, but the hole saw is not thick enough to go all the way through my top, so I'm going to have to do a little digging here to get it out a little bit. There we go. Gives me about 1/16 of an inch, maybe 1/8. So I don't know if that's going to be enough or not. I'm going to have to dig out a little bit more. Let's see what I can do here now. So that's going to give us enough. Just wanted enough so that I can see my hole through the top side. Yeah, fortunately, it gave me just barely enough to see it. I'm going to go through the top side. Got just barely enough hole here that I can tell where it came through. I'll start my hole in the top. A little slow to start with, so I don't score the hourglass. Drilled our first hole in our new QS boat. We got a nice smooth hole all the way down. The thing I didn't like is the pre-made plates were a hair smaller than a hole saw, so they got scratched up a little bit. I'm gonna have to put some paint on that. Other than that, looks pretty good. Underside looks good. I've got a hole for our grand slams to go in. If any of you are Key West boat followers and curious about the thickness of your hard top from the factory, it is exactly 2 inches. Exactly 2 inches thick in the hard top. Looks like the center is some kind of a hard foam type material. I'm not sure exactly what. And you got a layer of fiberglass on the bottom, layer of fiberglass on the top. Go ahead and remove all these bolts and get them out of my way. cities. Let's scroll them out from the bottom. All right, now it's telling me to drill my holes, put my taco in from the top, and mark my holes. But since we've got a pre-mounted underplate, we're going to drill from the bottom. Another thing it's telling you is if you have a hard top with a soft core, to use spacers. This is not exactly soft, it's kind of hard, but I kind of think I want to use spacers anyway, just to make sure I don't squeeze my top. So anyway, we're going to try to put a couple bolt holes in and see what happens. Five-sixteenths drill bit, just the size of the bolts. Everything looked fine. Starboard or port, in other words, to the outside of the boat. Okay, our holes are drilled out, cleaned up, ready for a dry fit. Our taco outriggers and my taco. The handles are going to go toward the outside of the boat or starboard on this side, port on the other side. Everything looks good. Everything looks real good. Pull holes lining up. Bring them back out. I need spacers. Spacers are used when you don't have you got a soft core. Or no core, causes when you compress the bolts down, it keeps it from compressing your top, causing cracks. I have to drill out a bigger hole if I want to use them. So I'm debating whether I want to use them or not because my core is not really hollow. I think I'm going to try it. At least I'm going to go with different type bolts because I couldn't find the ones I needed. So I'm going to put these on just to get me going and come back and replace them later with some stainless steel. The right type. So, just making sure everything is good. One more fit. Bolts through, make sure it works. Should be. Keep the rain from going down through the top. And we should be ready to place them. Here we are. Gonna get a Ram Slam 280s. MTO. Nice for a bead. Ground. Okay. It's on for the bottom. Using a locked up, make sure nothing moves later on. Okay, so we have our wrenches. We're going to start snugging up some bolts. Down to the underside for a minute. Some finished product up under there. Almost finished. Okay, I'm getting the handles in here. Maybe they make a special tool for this. It sure is a bitch where they're at. Now I've got to go back, take these off and put these fiber washers in below the stainless washers. It's on the last page of the book, so they read all the way through first. It says you must put these fiber washers under the stainless washers to keep the the bracket from corroding because it's two different metals. So now we're going to do that. These are 15 footers. Now we're going to go to the other side. These are not fully extended yet. A view of the outrigger from the other side of the boat. Start on the second side. But it seems to be a little easier if you point it out from the outside to get the Allen screws in. One more little turn. I think that's it. Alright, there we go. It's number two down. I think I'm finished. I'm going to clean up my tools and my mess. And we'll do a little overhaul. Okay, the final products are in. It's the Grand Slam 280 Outriggers on a 219 FS. Key West center console just installed. handle grips. To operate, just as simple as pulling down on it and turn it, lock it in place where you want it, come back. No standing on the rails like you do with the 280 standards. Tie all your rigging to your T-top, never have to stand on the bow. That's my install for the Grand Slam 280s. Catch you next time.